And we welcome you to the Stanley Cup playoffs from Toronto. It's game number three, the Boston Bruins and the Toronto Maple Leafs. The puck is loose, swooping back, Kapanen denied by Holden. And the Leafs now just clear it back in the Boston zone. It dies for Kapanen to the outside. Oh, what a save! Tuukka Rask on the young rookie, Andreas Janssen.
Tuukka Rask with the left hand fights that off. Nice distribution by Kapanen, and Janssen puts it on goal, and Tuukka Rask reads it. His mind was like a supercomputer there, Johnny.
He thought about melting that one down, and now Bozak out of the corner. Gets some help from Jake Gardner. Foot race won by Kapanen. Kasperi Kapanen's in. Rask again comes up big.
Now remember the other night, Kasperi Kapanen had a great chance on Tuukka Rask. Rask shut the door, and here he is tonight going around Nick Holden, who didn't gauge his speed very well. But watch the rolling puck. That's going to be the problem for Kapanen. He can never get it to sit down. See that thing on edge, Johnny?
Yeah.
And because of it, he can't get good wood. And Tuukka Rask comes out with the right pad and then eventually the glove. But you go back to the other night, that was a spectacular save by Tuukka Rask against Kasperi Kapanen.
Has been excellent. So the power play underway. Bozak with his shot. Rask to save. Van Riemsdyk scores! Seven seconds after the call of the penalty, the Leafs strike first. James Van Riemsdyk from his office.
It's amazing what the playoffs bring, the drama. You get a missed call. Go back to game one, a missed offside ended up costing the Leafs the game's first goal against. There's a missed call, it hits the glass, goes out. You get an opportunity to turn the game around and maybe even the series. Bozak bears down on the faceoff and then traffic in front. That's where James Van Riemsdyk has scored the majority of his goals all year long, and there couldn't be a bigger one for number 25 than that one.
A power play goal at 17:05. And a lead.
You see that there too. He got it up and over the pad. He went underneath the arm, and there was all kinds of dialogue after that as Nash still lamenting the missed call.
Jake DeBrusque on a forecheck here, trying to get away from Roman Polak. Good battle going on at the net. Anderson's been knocked back into the goal. This is going to be interesting. The puck didn't get in. Krejci couldn't beat Anderson.
Polak gets in on DeBrusque. DeBrusque. He's got his strap right around his nose. Somehow the puck stays alive. But while that was happening at the front of the net, you had Dermott and Nash. Nash knows where to go. Try to get to the front of the net. What would the call have been here? Did Dermott knock him in? But look at Anderson.
Wow. Pestered by Dominic Moore. Schaller digs it out. Canceled a bit by Pollock. Tim Schaller grinds it back. Here's McQuaid. Here it comes. He scores! Adam McQuaid will leak it through Frederick Anderson. We're tied.
John, before the game, we talked about the importance of Nolichari, Tim Schaller, and Sean Corrali, the grinders, the fourth line guys, not the Hollywood sexy guys, the guys that help you win because they have character, they're coachable, and they accept their roles. They're grinding hard on it. Schaller, here's McQuaid. You talked about a shot block in prowess. How about the shot? Through a maze, and Freddie Anderson, that's got some odor on it. That's got to be stopped. That goes right through him, and you can read the label on the puck as it crosses the line. The Bruins don't care. The grinders go to work, and McQuaid gets a goal, and we're all tied up.
It'll be his third career playoff goal early in this second period. Inspirational shift leads to the tying goal. Here's Pasternak from the blue line. Hard shot, missed the net. Shift after a goal is a good one for the Bergeron line. Puck's cleared down the ice. Marner has it. He breaks in front. Score! Patrick Marner! Seconds after the McQuaid goal, Marlowe from Marner, 2-1 Toronto.
You said in the first period that the Leafs have to play the way that they got here, and this is what they've done all year long. You're under pressure, you think you're going to go offensively, a long stretch pass that ends up going through the legs of the defenseman. Miller couldn't get it, and this is one for Marleau that he's reading. Marner's just trying desperately to control this puck. A hard pass, stick on the ice, and it goes right back the other way. Not much of a shot by Marleau, just a redirect, and you can see as Rask wasn't able to keep his five hole closed in his pad down, and that one trickled through the five.
Through center ice, Sean Corrali. Gardner closing the gap. Corrali throws on the brakes, off a skate, loose this way, it's Chara. He'll take it to the outside, Zdeno Chara scores! Top shelf, an opening provided by Frederik Andersen. And the Bruins captain gets it done. They tie it.
This all started 200 feet away from Freddie Andersen. We talked about the importance of the matchup. Watch Nick Holden. He makes the smart play, 44 and white. He doesn't turn it over. Tape to tape. Then you see McQuaid and Holden come off. Chara and McAvoy come on. Great job by Corrali moving the puck over. And then look at the skill level of 6'9" Zdeno Chara. Short side roof. What a spectacular shot, but that's team hockey right there, John. Holden understood his role, moved the puck, then they get Chara on the ice. He sticks it to the back of the net, 2-2.
Eric Staal scored a similar goal last night for the Minnesota Wild. Zdeno Chara sneaks it by Andersen.
Bergeron late in a long shift up the boards. Pastrnak couldn't get the puck out. Matthews keeps it in, can't get the shot. Hyman missed the net. This is a tired Bruin line. Maple Leafs, Nylander, side of the net. Matthews scores! Finally, points from Matthews and Nylander, and the Maple Leafs are in front again.
Constantly looking for a mismatch, and you mentioned this is a long shift for this entire line, forwards and defense. You can see the white sweater standing still. The Leafs jump to the loose puck, got a chance to get it out for Pastrnak, and what a play here by Nylander. And much like we saw, we didn't expect it from Zdeno Chara. You do expect it from Austin Matthews. Tight angle right over the elbow of Rask, and the sound of the bells going in, and there's that burst of reaction. Finally getting the first goal, feeling the intensity in this arena as well.
David Pastrnak did tired, had a couple of chances to get the puck out and couldn't do it along the board. There's a lot happened in the first 52 seconds of that power play. Here comes Pastrnak, stopped by Andersen. Marchand to Pastrnak, and they couldn't complete the play, but they're still on the power.
And that pass detected by James Van Riemsdyk. Three abreast. Come the Maple Leafs. Through the middle, it's Brown. Taken care of by Groop. Rask with a save off Bozak. Mark that one.
Bozak with a chance. Rebound for Van Riemsdyk, and he just can't get to the bouncing puck. Look at that. Wow.
Krejci got by Pekanics. Gets into the attacking zone. Lost the puck. Pekanics teams up with Marner. Out to Marleau. Two on one. Patrick Marleau shoots. He scores. Checking line. Marleau used the cannons as a decoy beautifully and makes it 4-2 Toronto.
Well, a couple things happen. It's all the back pressure there. Pekanics gets back. Marner keeps it alive. Now you've got a two-on-one, and watch just the little hesitation by Marleau. Looks like he's going to pass. Like you've seen most of this series so far, the defensive allowed the shooter to be taken by the goaltender. This is one just underneath, sort of that halfway shot by Marleau. I think Rask was thinking high glove, and instead it goes under, and what a big goal from this makeshift line that came together tonight.
16:25 of the third period, and a little bit of breathing room against the Boston Bruins in game number three. But he kept possession. Here's Torrey Krug walking in. David Krejci, slap pass, Pastrnak, what a save! A fantastic save by Andersen, and he's made a few of those tonight.
how many chances that the Bruins had here in the third period. Marchand crossbar, Pasternak post, and then look at this one. Boom.
Yeah, that's a great look. Stick inside the post. Wow.
Hard pass across right from David Krejci. Look at the reaction of Anderson, and wow. Oh, right across the goal line. That couldn't have been any better played by the Leaf netminder. Sprawling one way, getting back, and just somehow able to have enough on that blocker to hold that stick above the line.
And he deserves a standing ovation for that.
He reeled it in here tonight, big time.
Pasternak puts the puck in deep. Krejci's centering pass misses, and that'll do it.
Maple Leafs are back in the series with their first win, an impressive victory on home ice, 4-2 over the Bruins. A lot of things went right for the Boston Bruins in their first two games, and a lot of things went right for Toronto tonight.